Now that we've discussed atomic orbitals, and that we know each of these atomic orbitals have an energy associated with them, we can now begin to look at these atomic orbital energies to see how the electrons are going to occupy those orbitals. So I have two diagrams shown here at the top of this page. One on the left of a hydrogen atom, which has only one electron, and one on the right, which is a many-electron system, which is going to happen for all the other atoms that we're going to discuss. So on the left-hand side, in this one-electron system, since we only have one electron, there are no electron-electron repulsions. So when an electron fills a particular orbital, and we're going to look at these things called quantum numbers, the orbital energy is only associated by the energy level, or the principal quantum number. So notice that each of the orbitals here are of equal energy if they're in the same subshell. For instance, the 2s and the 2p orbital here are both the same energy. Okay? For a many-electron atom, we have more than one electron. So there can be more of a repulsion in some of the orbitals than there are for others. So what happens is that the 2s and the 2p orbital are not the same energy anymore. So we're going to have to take this into account when we look at these many electron atoms. And this is one of the things that the Bohr model failed on, is that it did not take into account the electron-electron repulsions that we have in these atoms. So this, both of these figures here for the hydrogen atom and the many electron atom are shown in your textbook. And there's also a little guide to show how we fill in these orbitals. And on the right hand side, this is the many electron atom, which will show how the electrons will fill into these orbitals. And again, the lowest energy is down here at the bottom, and it's going to fill those orbitals first. Okay, a little diagram used to show this is shown down here at the bottom of the page, where I list all the orbitals out. Okay, so we can kind of show that the electrons are going to fill in this order right here, where we start with the 1s, then we go to the 2s. The next orbital that's filled is the 2p, then the 3s, then the 3p, then the 4s, then after the 4s, we fill the 3d, then the 4p, then the 5s, after the 5s comes the 4d, then the 5p, then the 6s. The 6s is followed by the 4f, then the 5d, then the 6p, then we're going to fill the 7s, after the 7s comes the 5f, then the 4d, and so on. So this little diagram right here can kind of help you if you're struggling with figuring out how to draw this many electron atom diagram up here. So in addition to filling these orbitals, there's something called Hund's rule, and Hund's rule states that electrons enter orbitals of equal energy singly with parallel spins before they become paired. And this rule is going to help us when we look at our electron configurations and our electron diagrams. Here, this introduces something called electron spin. And there are two ways an electron can spin. We can say spin up and spin down, which means that these spins are going to be in opposite directions. Typically, when we are drawing these diagrams, we designate the electron spins with either an up arrow or a down arrow, the up being for the up spin, the down being for down spin. So in the next video, we're going to look at how the orbitals can hold these electrons, how many can go in there, and how we would go through and make something called that we refer to as electron configurations and electron block diagrams.